Hi guys, it's just gone 12:30, so it's now technically Wednesday morning, Wednesday the 24th, I've not done a lot for the last couple of days. Well, apart from make that computer yesterday, which sold today. Before I continue, just want to send my thoughts and prayers and condolences to all those affected by the terror attack in Manchester. Thoughts with you all. It's a dreadful world we're living in at the minute, isn't it? All these proxy terror attacks and crap. Anyway, I had a friend, Mr. Annoying Friend, pop up yesterday. His friend had a couple of laptops he wanted to get rid of. I was going to buy them, but they're both pretty much dead. Well, there's an Acer over there, which is missing its screen and bezel, but doesn't want to turn on either. I plugged it in. The charge light comes on, but that's it. You press the power button, nothing happens. So, to me, it's not worth doing anything with it. Only had RAM in it as well, didn't have nothing else. No hard drive or anything, so the other one is a Toshiba that I've got down here. I've actually got two. I've got the one I got with that. Big job lot of various computers and printers and whatnot, which is dead, doesn't power on, and this bloody one does the same thing, it doesn't power on. I have actually, chances are it's the motherboard on both, well I know it's the motherboard on the other one. So the chances are it's probably a motherboard issue on this one. But I've looked on eBay and I can't find one. So, it may not. I will open this up and have a better look inside that. It's a shame if it doesn't work, because it's got an i3 processor on it. I've also got a desktop over there. Now, pardon me, it's a Lenovo ThinkCentre Edge 72, and he was going to trade it, but I haven't really got anything worth trading it for. He wanted a laptop or something. I don't have any spare laptops. I've got my Acer, which I use, and my little netbook, which I also use. Which is actually pretty slow, but I do use it. So he said about, I don't know why, I just left it as it was, but he was going to recase the motherboard in this one into another computer case, but we found that the RAM that was in it was dead. And I don't have any spare. Well, I do, but it's for this PC, my main PC. That's why I keep it, because it was a pair that I bought, but the PC I'm using can only take 8 GB max, and they're 8 GB sticks, so I could only put one in this machine. So I just kept the other one as a spare, so I couldn't really give him that one. So in the end, he just said, keep the computer, because he got it for nothing anyway. That's probably why he got it for nothing. So, I decided just out of boredom to build it up. So I've got a nice Lenovo ThinkCentre over there with an i5 processor, which has got 4 cores, 2.9 gigahertz. My 8 gigabyte stick in there. I know there's a problem with one of the DIMM slots on there, which doesn't help because my brother did some research and said it can take 16 gigabytes. Well, that one won't because only one slot works, unless there's a 16 gigabyte stick out there. If there isn't, then that's not going to take 16 gigs. I just threw in one of my hard drives, actually threw in my 500 gigabyte. Threw in a couple of fans, small ones. I'll show you the computer in a minute. And a 500 watt power supply. Because for some reason I had the wrong one in there. Which probably didn't help with the way it worked, but even with a different power supply, we still got nothing out to the mono when we used that 4 gigabyte stick. So, anyway, and like you said, he actually wants a laptop, so maybe if I can get a laptop working, I could do some sort of deal with him. Yeah, let's show you that then, shall we? Not doing much at the minute. Should have Cat's Custom Trikes popping up tomorrow. She's got a ladies' mountain bike for me. So she's going to ride that here. I'll put whatever tyre or tyres I can find on her racer and just throw that front brake cable on. So I still haven't done that yet. I just find I've got to be in the right mood to do certain things like that. Anyway, let's turn you around. There's the Lenovo, or at least the arse end of the Lenovo. I actually like it because it's a very nice, you know, small form factor case. I've got a USB Wi-Fi dongle plugged into the back and an Asus video card plugged in it. So that there really isn't a lot of room in there, so where are we not doing? Oh, it's because I knocked the switch, that's why. Oddly enough, the switch was neither in the on position or off position. It was sort of halfway between each. Which is bad, because that could have arced. It's rather loud because of that fan. And because of the lack of cooling in this, because of the lack of cooling in that, because it's only got a little fan sort of bodged in the front of this machine. You just see my hand, can't you? And a little one on the back is, I'm actually tempted to recase this into another thing. Mind you, it's not getting hot, so I don't know what this error is. Memory size decreased. I increased it, so I'll piss off. Bloody thing. Just F2, put a 64-bit version of Windows 10 on this. I've actually noticed Windows 10 doesn't take that long to install. This doesn't take that long to boot either. Excuse me. I actually think I'm just going to leave this as it is. It's got a nice little carry handle up here saying, what are you doing? Updating Steam, so I've got that so it updates automatically. I'm going to build it as an actual backup to my PC. I might actually use this one as the editing rig if I can find somewhere to set it up. Because, as you know, my one, saving it in high definition, this is the reason I haven't been saving it in high def. strangles my process and I can't really do anything else on the PC until it's saved. So I'm toying with the idea of using this one. And my god, that metal is cold. Maybe the cooling isn't going to be a problem in this. I feel air coming out of here, so... So far I've thrown on power ISO. Do I use that to burn any discs that I need burned? I've got my AVG antivirus, Firefox. I've actually been using a bit of Microsoft Edge lately. It doesn't seem that bad, to be honest. I might use it a bit more. So I've even though I've been using Windows 10 for well over a year now, I've never really used Microsoft Edge, so... I'm actually liking this, to be honest. Why it's giving me the London weather, I don't know. I'm not in London. Whoops. Okay, doesn't want to change. MSN, obviously powered by Bing. Headlines. Might actually run my experiment tomorrow and run Firefox and not Firefox, Facebook in Edge and see if it runs any better. So I'm actually finding Firefox to be too much of a pain in the ass lately. I don't know if anyone else has, or ever has had problems with Firefox, where it stops responding. Close that, don't need that open. And the downside is, it's noisy. But that noisy fan is actually really blowing the air out the back here. It really is. That's why I picked it. But, I'm going to go ahead and shut this down. Excellent. So we've got the one card slot on the front here as well for an SD card. If I just turn it that way. Front of this machine, there we go. Yeah, it's only got the one card slot, it's got a big button there for the DVD drive, two USBs, and the usual audio, and then just big thing on there. It's actually quite smart because I know a lot of small form factor cases still have the two bays for your CD drives or whatever, but this has only got the one, and to me, you only need the one anyway. I only ever use one, so I've never had a use for two, so I used to put more than one on just because I could. Never used them, never had a use, you know, I never copied CDs or anything, but... I still put them on there. Oh, it's actually cooling down in this flat quite nicely now. I actually find that this time of year, this flat gets pretty bloody warm. And I've actually got a heat rash right where I don't want it, or on my ass cheek, of all places. And they itch, and they get bloody sore. Yeah, I don't mind summer. Well, I don't, my body does. Because, all of this psoriasis crap, which is incurable, unfortunately, I itch when I get hot. So not only do I have a sweating problem, because I do sweat quite a lot, I don't actually have to do a lot to start sweating. I don't know, maybe the diabetes has a little something to do with that. Oops. My friend has said goodnight and I didn't see, never mind. Yeah, I get bloody itchy as well, so I get uncomfortable. That's, I think, what really pisses me off the most. I can't just enjoy... I remember as a kid, I used to love the sun. I used to love summer, love going outside. You know, love playing games with all the other kids on the estate and whatnot. But then again, when I was a kid, my psoriasis wasn't present. It's a genetic disorder, so I think I must have been in my early 20s when I first started seeing little signs of it. I'm not kidding, it started as a little dinky patch like that, I believe, on my left leg. But now it's everywhere. I'm almost a walking red rash, basically. No, not the most pleasant of things to look at, is it? It's my dad that's got it, and like I said, it's genetic, and it's a dominant gene as well. So if I did have kids, my kids are almost guaranteed to have it as well. It's actually quite nice sitting here with the fan behind me. Anyway, I'm going to shut the video down, because I'm getting tired. I've got friends are logging off for the night as well. And I need to get out of my clothes, because that actually allows my skin to breathe, and I'm a lot more comfortable. Because normally, this time of year, I'm around the flat like this. Because you get bloody hot. It gets hot up here anyway. Because as I've said before, I've got the window at the front there. That is literally the whole width of the lounge. Huge panes of glass, double glazing, kind of turns this lounge into a greenhouse. Especially when the sun comes round, because the sun blares straight in those windows in summer. Oh, that is lovely right round the neck. Don't even think about it, because, never mind. He's on my lap again. Right, thanks a lot for watching. Just thought I'd give you a little update on those laptops I've got and that computer. Not sure what I'm going to do with these laptops yet. I think they're just going to be eBay relics. Which I'll have to... post of our My Hermes. Anyway, if you liked the video, you know what to do. Give me a thumbs up or a thumbs down if you didn't like it. And I will talk to you all again, probably tomorrow. Bye.